I'm Dr. Sreenivas Murthy TM. What causes tonsillitis in adults, and if left untreated, would it cause problems? Now, what causes tonsils makes no sense, because tonsils are normal organs in every human being. It is there in every human being. If you ask any person to open the mouth, you will see two roundishly irregular structures on the sides of the throat behind the tongue. So every human being who opens the mouth, we should be able to see that. This is a lymphoid tissue, and it has been placed by nature exactly at that point, because that is where food and water enter the body along with the air that we breathe. So any germ entering into the body is trapped by these lymphoid tissues, so that it will not enter the body directly without getting filtered. Now when it hits the tonsils will throw an inflammatory response. So any inflammation will cause pain, swelling, redness, fever. So these are the common symptoms with which the body will tend to fight it off. Now if we take medication, we can control pain, fever and the redness which swelling happens, usually in 2 to 3 days time. So all you need is an antibiotic or an anti-inflammatory drug. But supposing this infection has been caused by a bacteria, then you will need some antibiotic. So that is usually decided by the doctor based on your symptoms, how you have been responding to medication. And sometimes we may resort to certain laboratory tests, namely a culture. We can take a throat swab, send it for culture. We usually get culture reports in 48 to 72 hours. Or sometimes there can be children who get what is called as strep tonsils, or adults also can get strep tonsils. That means you are infected with a bacteria called Streptococcus. Now this has been known to cause a lot of problems in people who get a strep throat. This particular bacteria is known to release certain toxins which can affect the heart, the joints, the kidney. Hence, there is a fear of streptococcal infection. But how can it be identified? It can be identified with a culture, throat swab, or by serial blood tests. That means when we say serial blood test, just doing one particular blood test on one particular occasion would not lead us to that diagnosis. We may have to repeat it 2 or 3 times, and then we have to see the titres, whether the antibodies which are being developed against that particular toxin is increasing in subsequent titres. Then that would diagnose a strep throat. Now if we don't treat a strep throat, then it will lead to problems. But because of the advent of antibiotics, we have seen that the number of who have got affected by strep throat leading complication of the kidney, of the heart or the joints have grossly reduced in today's world. I remember as a young medical student, we would see a lot of people suffering from rheumatic heart disease and the same causing problems to the joint and kidney. But in today's world, we don't come across this as frequently, probably because most doctors are using antibiotics at the appropriate time. Tonsils, as I was talking about, it can get infected once in a while, can get infected frequently, that is recurrent tonsils, or in some people we call it as chronic tonsillitis, where harbor bacteria which can cause infections within the gland itself, and at certain situations they tend to flare up. Now people who tend to have this kind of chronic or recurrent infections, they can have bad breath emanating from the oral cavity because of bacteria which can cause infections being within the tonsil or residing within the tonsil.